My name is Clemens Musterle, and I'm a team lead for rendering development here at Enscape. DLSS stands for Deep Learning Supersampling, a technology developed by NVIDIA. DLSS uses machine learning to produce a high-resolution image from a series of lower-resolution images, which means your graphics card must do the full shading computations only for fractions of the pixels of your monitor's resolution, which is of course much faster, but you still get image quality that is comparable to rendering in native resolution. Dedicated AI hardware called tensor cores on your NVIDIA RTX series graphics card accelerates the neural network responsible for the smart upscaling behind DLSS. We are currently experiencing two trends in real-time rendering at the same time. On the one hand, monitors or VR headsets with ultra-high-resolution displays are becoming more and more popular, skyrocketing the amount of pixels we have to push. On the other hand, real-time ray tracing becomes more and more important to fulfill our customers' expectations of exceptional real-time image quality in Enscape. However, tracing a lot of rays still costs a lot of performance. DLSS allows us to bring these conflicting requirements together. We can push rendering quality further, and DLSS allows us to compensate the additional performance cost. So if you previously struggled to get a smooth walkthrough experience on your 4K monitor resolution, your frame rate with DLSS will now be almost 3 times as high. It is a time of being constantly at full alert and where effective communication with everyone is key. You have to ensure everything is finished in time, but without sacrificing quality. Well, when starting with the DLSS integration, we've set everything up, but the image simply remained completely black. We were investigating that for hours, but we didn't get anywhere. Fortunately, NVIDIA offered great developer support, and they told us there was simply a single flag missing in our setup code, which we missed in the documentation. From that point on, it took almost no time to get the first prototype working.